Mayong aga sa atong tanan. Before we proceed sa atong online worship proper, we will be doing a short review of what we learned last Sunday. So last Sunday, it is Resurrection Sunday, and we studied about the significance of Christ's resurrection. So for those of you nga wala ka join sa aton, kung wala pa nakalantaw sa aton gintunan last Sunday, you could watch in our YouTube channel para man sa aton nga Facebook page. So the significance of Christ's resurrection. And if there's one statement that would summarize all the things that we learned last Sunday, it's this: that our faith was completed, for Christ has risen from the dead. Nga ang ginatuuhan mo, ang ginatuuhan ko, ang ginatindugan naton, as Apostle Paul would tell us in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 15, ginhambal niya, I declare unto you the gospel which I preached unto you and wherein ye also stand. So in this passage, Apostle Paul would give us the idea and would teach us that the significance of the gospel, the significance of the resurrection, the death, burial, and the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ makes our faith complete. And together with that, there are several significant truths that we could learn about the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ. Why is it so important para sa aton, kag sa aton ginatuhan? Why it made our faith complete? So number one, learn that Christ's resurrection verifies the credibility of the scriptures. I think most of you have known about this one, that thousands and hundreds and thousands of years ago, before Christ has died and was buried and then he was resurrected from the dead, there are prophecies after prophecies nga nagahambal na about the death, burial, and the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ. So to be able to see that and sa natabo na gitna, it verifies, it gives to us, it supports that credibility nga ang pulong sang Ginoo, they are unified and they are truly speaking the truth. It is credible. Of course, it is called the Word of God. And the second significant truth nga makita naton about the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ and why it made our faith complete is this: because Christ's resurrection, it solidifies the identity of Jesus Christ. It presented to us that indeed the Lord Jesus Christ is the Messiah. He is the Savior. He is the one that will die for us. And together with that, He is also the Son of God, the one who died and that was resurrected from the dead. And right now, He is sitting in the right hand of the throne of God. That's what the Bible tells us so. And then the last significant truth that we learned last Sunday is this: that Christ's resurrection secures the hope of every believer. Our hope, my hope, and your hope in this life is not the popularity of this world, it's not the stability, it's not the security that the world offers. Our hope is because the Lord Jesus Christ has been risen from the dead. Our hope is His promise that some near in the future, He will come again and He will take us. He will take you, He will take me. And then we will finally experience the victory that He has given for all of us. So last Sunday, these are the things that we learned, and we can summarize it with this one. Our faith was completed, for Christ has risen from the dead. So I hope and I pray that you will continually to tune in, and that you will study more about truths in the scriptures. And we believe that what we're going to study this morning is related as well to the significance of Christ's death, burial, and resurrection. Good morning. Sunday, everyone. Welcome to our online worship proper. And before we will proceed to the study of the scriptures this morning, let us first listen to a hymn and to a special music.
His throne and his king. that he gave willingly to rescue a sinner like me.
We praise God for the message of the song that we listened. And I hope and I pray that you are now ready to study with me, together with me, the scriptures. And for those who do not know and do not understand about this one, for a few weeks ago, last month, I think it was last month, we are doing a series in the book of Romans. And because of this COVID-19, it has to stop. And a lot of things happened. And we decided to preach more on the topic that is related to COVID-19. But as we ponder more on that, I think there are a lot of preachers who are right now doing everyday, daily dosage of spiritual truths and scriptures that we listen to every day. And we are thankful. We are thankful for those preachers, for those teachers of God's Word, that has given us encouragement every day of our lives, reminding us that God is good, that God is faithful, that God is merciful in our lives. This morning, we will continue our study in the book of Romans. We are now in chapter 3, and this is the pinnacle of the first part of the book of Romans. Here, Apostle Paul would give us the climax, the final statements, quoting some passages from the Old Testament to give to us the idea. Kung nga kinahanglan gid naton tuuhan ang gospel. Kung nga importante gid that we will not be ashamed of the gospel. And that to show to us that indeed the power of God that can save the people, that can save you and me, that can save the Jews and the Gentiles alike, it is only the gospel. So we will try to understand about that this morning as we study Romans chapter 3. We will be reading verse 9 going to verse 20. Just follow me with your eyes as we read this one. Romans chapter 3 verse 9 says, "What then? Are we better than they? No, in no wise. For we have before proved, both Jews and Gentiles, that they are all under sin. As it is written, there is none righteous, no, not one. There is none that understandeth, there is none that seeketh after God. They are all gone out of the way, they are together become unprofitable. There is none that doeth good, no, not one. Their throat is an open sepulchre, with their tongues they have used deceit. The poison of asps is under their lips, whose mouth is full of cursing and bitterness. Their feet is swift to shed blood. Destruction and misery are in their ways, and the way of peace have they not known. There is no fear of God before their eyes. Now we know that what things soever the law saith, it saith to them who are under the law, that every mouth may be stopped, and that all the world may become guilty before God. Therefore, by the deeds of the law, there shall no flesh be justified in his sight, for by the law is the knowledge of sin." Let us pray as we continue our study. Lord, what we are going to read and what we are going to study this morning is one of the hardest and one of the heaviest topics in the scriptures. This is the kind of topic, O Lord, that we are uncomfortable talking about, because it would show to us the reality of how depraved we are as sinners. So I pray, O Lord, that may you will allow your word to be able to be understood by those who are listening this morning. Not all of us will be reminded, Jews and Gentiles, believers and unbelievers, that all of us will be reminded about the reality, about the truth, of the seriousness of our sin. That maybe for us, we would tolerate sins in our lives. But in your presence, O Lord, in your eyes, you could never tolerate sin, because you are holy. And that is why you have to judge us, because you are a righteous judge. So Lord, as we open your word, as we study it again this morning, we pray that may it is your word and the truth from it that will be shown, that will remind your people, and that we will continually appreciate the love, the grace, and the mercy that you have given to all of us. Thank you, O Lord, for your word. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. So for those of you who have been with us, especially sa mga taga Don Causeway, and for those of you who have studied the book of Romans, we know, and I shared this one to you before, that the key verses in the book of Romans is found in verse 16 going to verse 17. And the more you read, and the more you study the book of Romans, you will clearly understand kung aamoy ni ang foundational verses throughout the whole book. Now, ginamit rin ni Apostle Pablo, "For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation, to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first, and also to the Greek." And then he said in verse 17, "For therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by faith." So here in the foundational, in the key verse of the book of Romans, ginahambalan ni Apostle Pablo dire. Ngambal niya, manya, "I will never be ashamed. I will never be afraid of proclaiming, of sharing about the life, the death, and the burial, and the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ." We would summarize that as the gospel. Why? Because Apostle Paul clearly understands and is confident with this one. nothing in this world that can save, that can bring salvation to your life and to my life, aside from the gospel about the life of the Lord Jesus Christ. So, Apostle Pablo dire, he is not ashamed of this one. And this gospel, this gospel that would give us the salvation, it is the only way for us to receive the righteousness of God. And that is why the theme of the book of Romans is this one, that God's righteousness is given to those who put their faith in Jesus Christ. That if you're going to study the book of Romans, this is the theme, this is the progressive theme that you can see in the book of Romans. At the very first part of it, actually in the first three chapters, hindi pa lang kita subong, we talk about that every person, all human beings, no one is excused about this one. We are not exempted to the truth that we are lacking of God's righteousness. Why? Because we are all under sin. Ikaw ba ko wala excuse? And kung ari ka mo dire sa previous ginatanong yung pangtunaan about few months ago, those few weeks, it is a heavy topic actually. Because I just don't want you to understand, or I just don't want the church people to think that I am condemning them, telling them that they are this. I would like them to understand, and I would like you to understand that this is not my words. This is the scriptures. As hard as it is for me to speak about this one, I have to share it. Why? Because this is very important for you and for me to clearly understand that without the grace, without the mercy of the Lord Jesus Christ, this is the reality of our lives. We are sinners. And because we lack the righteousness of God, we could never enter the presence of God. Now, together with that, we learn about the purpose of the book of Romans as well. And the first purpose na makita natin dira is Paul is expressing his desire, that he desires to be with them, to go to them, and to minister to them, and as well as that his heart will be comforted through their lives as well. But the main reason kung ang gisulat ni Apostle Pablo ini ng book of Romans is this, it is to present the complete gospel. And what was interesting, in this whole book of Romans, in this presentation of Apostle Paul, that his audience, ang iya diri nga ginasulatan, they are not unbelievers. They are people who already called brethren in the scriptures. They are people who believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, thereby they are saved. So why is it that it is important for Apostle Paul to share to them and to present to them the complete gospel again and the applications of the gospel later on in the second half of the book of Romans? I think we have to be reminded again that the effectivity of the gospel is not just about saving us. But the gospel, it is still the power of God. It is what motivates us to be progressively sanctified and to be more like Christ. The more we understand the truth about the gospel, the more we understand about the reality of how much God has sacrificed, we will appreciate more, and that we will be more grateful. And it will motivate us to be able to obey and to follow Him, whatever the cost. Because He has given us, it cost Him everything. So the first part of the book of Romans, which is the first three chapters, we talk about that everyone is guilty. All are found guilty before the judgment of the only righteous judge. You and I, we are never qualified to judge one another. We do not have the right to judge and to point fingers. Ikaw, amo ka na, ikaw, hindi kaya pwede magpalangit, kaya grabe ka makasala. We do not have that right. Only God has the right to judge who He desires to judge and who He knows deserves judgment. And you do know, tanan kita, we deserve that this judgment. So for the Gentiles, we learn, this is just the major of it, we learn that the Gentiles are arrogant. Actually, not just the Gentiles, but all men, all people. Arrogant, disobedient, they are rebellious, these are their sins. And then, of course, idolatry. We see also that the people of Israel have this kind of sins as well. But together with that, there are specific areas we're going to learn natin about the people of Israel. And we learn that the spiritual heritage of the Jewish people will not spare them from God's righteous judgment. No matter how great their spiritual heritage is, it will never spare them because all are under sin. All are guilty. The spiritual knowledge as well, the second thing we learn natin about the Jewish people, or the learn na natin ini, the spiritual knowledge of the Jewish people will not spare them from God's righteous judgment. And then the third one, yung mag-learn natin about the Jewish people, is this, the physical ceremonies of the Jewish people will not spare them from God's righteous judgment. Their sacrifices, it will not spare them. Why? Because all are under sin. All are guilty before the judgments of the righteous judge. Now this would prove to us that God really is a righteous judge. Does every person must believe and trust that God was, is, and will always be absent of favoritism and partiality? As we continue, Apostle Paul would remind us this statement again throughout these first three chapters of the book of Romans, who tell us that all are found guilty before the judgment of the only righteous judge. And then as we continue, as we reach in the book of Romans chapter 3, here is what we read. Apostle Paul said, "What then? Are we better than they?" Now, probably and most scholars would say he is talking here to the Jewish believers in Rome. And he would tell them, "Do you think are we better than all the people in the world? Do you think are we better than the Gentiles? Do you think are we better than the barbarians and the unlearned?" And he said, "No, we are not. For we have before proved," and he hit the nail here. And he said, "Both Jews and Gentiles, that they are all under sin." Chapter 1 and chapter 2 is a very heavy chapter to read. It would talk to us, and there are some things there that are not child friendly. And there are some believers who don't want to read those parts because it reminds them of the things that they might be doing in this present age. But that's the reality. No one is exempted. All are under sin. So to continue with this argument, with these statements, and the following verses, starting from verse 10, going to verse, if I'm not mistaken, going to verse 18, are series of quotations from the Old Testament passages, mostly in the book of Psalms, and some are in the book of Isaiah. It is the quotations wherein Apostle Paul would give us the final argument that indeed, as it is written, there is none righteous. There is no people in the world. No one. No, not one. There is no one that has the identity of being righteous. So what does it mean? There is no one that can be able to enter the presence of God. So he starts here, as it is written, there is none righteous, and if you can see, the no, not one, it was also at the last part of this portion of his argument, it was ended as well with this phrase, no, not one. And I will be pointing out that to you later on. He said here, ang bali din eh, there is no righteous. Wala, di siya makita. Wala matarong. And as he go to be specific later on about the words that we say, about the actions that we are doing, it will hit. We could never, parang wala, hindi kita kalikaw. Siya ni. But he would continue with quoting from the Old Testament passage, there is none that understandeth. There is none that seeketh after God. Now this is the verses sa Bible na ma-prove sa aton, na nag-aambag sa aton, that without the grace of God, without God extending His grace and His mercy in our lives, wala sa aton sa makaintindi, wala sa aton sa magapangita sa Diyos. There was never in the rebellious heart of man, there was never in the arrogant heart of man na i-desire ang pangitahaon ng Diyos. And you see in the Old Testament passages that it was God who extended His grace first to those people, and then they responded to the grace of God by faith. And that is why God blessed them. Remember Noah, Abraham, it was God who extended it first. That is His grace to them. Why? Because in our human nature, there is none that understandeth. There is none that seeketh after God. Now that might be hard to understand in our lives. Number mo, Pastor Pat, before pa ako naging Christian, ginapangita ko ng Diyos. Napangkot man ko about sa Ginoo. I think this, that is a part that I seek after God as well. Are you sure that God is not involved with the desire in your heart? We believe that one of the explanations that I read about this one before is this one. That before we are saved, the Holy Spirit is beside us, guiding us, convicting us, giving us the, let's just say, the motivations as well, the convictions, using our conscience to seek God. And through that convicting power of the Holy Spirit, it was led to us, the person that will share to us the gospel. And it was also the Holy Spirit, we have to understand this one. It is also the Holy Spirit that allows us to clearly understand the scriptures and about the gospel. And then we respond to it because we understood. Now that's, I will not dwell more on that. That's God's part. But that's what we read in the scriptures. There is none that understandeth. There is none that seeketh after God. Verse 12. They are all gone out of the way. They are all lost. We are all lost. God, when God created us, God has given us a wonderful plan and purpose. And all had gone out the way. They are together become unprofitable. We became useless. And then the last one, there is none that doeth good. There is no good person. There is no good person. Remember in the conversation of the Lord Jesus Christ and one of the Pharisees, or I think it was a lawyer that told him, he told the Lord Jesus Christ, good master, good teacher. Then Christ told him, who is good? Only God is good. Only God is good. There is none that doeth good because there is none that is righteous. And this portion is ended as well with the phrase, no, not one. What does it mean? Nga-agin liwat kini Apostle Pablo ang phrase na no, not one. He is emphasizing the point here. That if you would look around the world, according in all history, except the Lord Jesus Christ, there is no man. No matter their positions, no matter how intelligent they are, no matter how strong they are, there is no one that is righteous. All are under sin and all are guilty under the judgment of the righteous judge. And as he proceeds, he quoted some specific, actually mga he compared some parts of the body, and then he would give us this picture of how that part of the body can give us the meaning as well, together with that. So he continues, he starts with this one, that their throat is an open sepulcher. Corrupt. You have to understand that a sepulcher is a place where a dead person is laid. As the dead person there is rotting and is being brought back into the dust, decomposing process. And in that process, amo na ang rason nga ginaseal ina kaya aman the stench, kabaho. Hindi manami si Muton. It would even put to the part to the point nga you will vomit if you inhale of that one. So here the ginahatag diri nga mga picture ni Apostle Paul as he would use the Old Testament passages is that the throat, the words of those people who are sinful, who are not righteous, basically our words before we believe in the Lord Jesus Christ is this: it is corrupt, sinful, wicked. Observe our world today. Cursings and all the tanan na lang na pamuyayaw. I have seen videos of young children, young na gani children, yung children ko pa, because they were too young. Kabata yun. Kabalo na sila mag... And who taught them that? Of course, the older ones, may nabatian sila ng gumaya, but you have to understand that in their heart, that is already in there. In your heart and in my heart. Actually, bisan hindi ka matudluan mga tao sa palibot mo. It is there. Naaman. That is our nature, and that's the sad truth, okay? Not only that, the second picture na ipakita ni Apostle Pablo is not about the corrupt words that comes out from our mouth. Of course, the words that comes out, nagaling na sa tatap ng tagpusoon, ito pa una muna. But the second thing na makita natin din yung brother, with their tongues, they abuse this. They are dishonest. To be honest with you, we are dishonest. We don't need a person to teach us to lie. It is part of our nature, as the more you observe. Kung kabalo kita nga may sala, kita nga habilo kita, nabara natin sala, we lie. And that is our nature. Our tongues were used for deceit, dishonesty. The next one, the poison of asp is under their lips. Our words are damaging and destructive. How many lives are destroyed because of words that should not have been said. Words na balon, ay kamamu sa imo. Words na ay, wala ka pulos. Words na tanik, wala ka nalang kagimbata. I mean, actually sa mga, nabati-batikan ko lang manang sa mga videos ko nga na iban sa drama na nalantaw ko. But if those things really happen, I'm thankful that akong parents, akong families are not like that. Even though before kami naging Christian, hindi damaging their words. Of course, I've seen them doing the cursings as well. The next one, and the last one in this portion, is this one about the words that comes out from our mouth. Not only that it's corrupt, dishonest, damaging, or destructive. And then the last one is blasphemous. A mouth full of cursings and bitterness. And the worst about this one, about our status in this being sinful, abang Apostle Pablo diri, it would lead us to be murderers. Listen close to this one. He said, their feet are swift to shed blood. Like Cain, nagselos lang siya. Pinatay niya na si Abel. Starts there. And Lamech, if I'm not mistaken, he sinned greater than Cain. Madali, destruction and misery are in their ways, and the way of peace have they not known. Hindi ko na lagi may pag isa-isahon what this one truly means. But hindi natin makita ang nature sa isang kataong na wala pag-ibig nakakilala sa Diyos. He has no respect of the life that God has given man, that God has given to a person. He has no desire for peace. What only desires are the misery and the destruction of others. And you know why? In verse 18, the root of them all, the main statement ng Ibuhay ng Apostol Pablo is one. Because there is no fear of God before their eyes. A person who is not yet saved, a person who do not yet received the grace and the mercy of the Lord Jesus Christ, of God, of the Lord Jesus Christ. A person who have not yet received the righteousness of God because of the Lord Jesus Christ. There is no fear of God before their eyes. And there are a lot of scripture passages where they would just say those kind of things. Kung nga, they would just do those wickedness, those violent and brutal things. Why? Because there is no fear of God in their hearts. And we could read these verses in the book of Psalms, in the book of Proverbs, that the fear of the Lord is what? Is the beginning of wisdom. Now without a person, if a person does not fear God, and a lot of times, it may not be all the time, but most of the time, it will lead to wickedness. Kung ang person who thinks that he is the only authority of his life, it happened in the book of Judges. According to history, according to the scriptures, the time came in the book of Judges that they will just do everything that they think is right. They will just do everything that they think is good in their own lives. And you know what happened? Murders, rapings, and a lot of violent and wickedness happened in that time of Judges. Why? Because there is no fear of God in their eyes. There is no fear. And you know, amo man ini ang atong status, amo gid ini kita. There is no respect for God. There is no reverence for God. There is no desire to worship God. No wonder, ambasang pulong sa Ginoo, we are all under sin. And he ended this part by saying to us, ambal niya, that all these things we know. Now we know that what things soever the law saith, it saith to them who are under the law. That every mouth may be stopped, and that all the world may become guilty before God. The law, number 3, verse 20, therefore by the deeds of the law, there shall no flesh be justified in his sight, no good works. If you could be able to follow the law, and we know we could not completely, perfectly follow the law. So in humble day, for by the law is the knowledge of sin. God has given us the law so that we will clearly understand how sinful we are, how opposite we are to his true nature. I know we could have said more on this, we could have quoted more verses, pero balok kung isasahon pagin natin, padaluman pagin natin, initanan, we will take hours of studying the scriptures. So I will just end it here. I think you get what Apostle Paul is trying to tell us here in this climax of his statement.
Humble, kinahumble niya lang ang Moses. All are found guilty before the judgment of the only righteous judge. Wala kita likaw. Wala ikaw likaw. And that is the importance kung ang aging balikan ginaton ini tuon. Kaya nga, kabalo ka mo anong rason na napatay si Kristo Jesus? And why we are appreciating the Resurrection Sunday? It's because we are sinners. Yet, while we are still sinners, Christ died for us. God is willing to sacrifice and to give us His only Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, so that we could escape this guilt, so that we could escape this condemnation of being sinners, so that we may have the opportunity to be righteous in His eyes, so that we can have the opportunity to understand His Word, to understand what He is trying to tell us, so that we can have the opportunity to seek Him, and to fear Him, and to worship Him, that our lives will be changed, your life will be changed, that our words will be, instead of cursings, of blasphemy, of those wicked things, of those things na nag-wasatan-baba, we could exchange it with praise, and with glory, and with worship sa Ginoo naton. That's the importance why we have to understand this truth. Kaya nga man, kung hindi ko maintindihan, kung hindi ko ma-appreciate, kung ano kabugat ang ginobra ni Kristo Jesus sa aton. We will just remain on thinking that we deserve what Christ has given us. Let me tell you this frankly and clearly, we do not deserve that love that God has given us. What we truly deserve, what you and I truly deserve, is hell and condemnation because we are all sinners. And I hope you will not hate me for saying that because that is the truth. But listen closely to this. The scriptures did not end there. The scriptures tell us, yes, that is the truth. Reality of our life. Without God, without Christ, we are truly guilty, we are sinners. But thanks be to God, because Apostle Paul was never ashamed. But thanks be to God, because the Lord Jesus Christ came to this world, and He saved as well this man, and this man went on to journeys and to be able just to proclaim the scriptures, to proclaim about the gospel. And we are praising God, you know why? Because despite of the reality of our sinfulness, despite of the reality kung ano kita ka depraved, ano kita ka nubo sa panulukan sa Diyos tungod sa atong sala, God has given us the opportunity to be saved. God has given us the salvation. Paano? If you and I will believe, madali, not everyone that believeth the gospel of Christ. The gospel ginwali ni Apostle Pablo, the gospel that is the reason why Christ has to come to this earth so that you and I will have the opportunity to be saved and to receive God's righteousness and to be cleansed from the guilt of sin and to be able to come into the presence of God to join Him and for all eternity. It is not because we deserve that. It is because God extended out of His great love, He extended His grace and He gave to us the Lord Jesus Christ. And there is only one way to escape sin. It is to have a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. It is to believe. Believe the gospel. Wala na. Magbay pa. There is no other name given to men under heaven except the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, so that everyone who believes may be saved. I hope and I pray na kung may ari sa ato, gapamati. And you have not yet realized that you need to humble yourselves before the presence of God. That you have to humble yourselves to tell God, Lord, makasala din ako. Kinahanglan ko si Kristo Jesus sa akong kabuhay. Kung wala niyo pa naging bra, humble yourselves, admit that you are a sinner. Humble mo sa Ginoo, Lord, makasala ako. When you talk to God, when you open your heart sa Ginoo, if God, through the Holy Spirit, is convicting you right now, confess all your sins sa Ginoo, my Lord, I believe that despite that I am a sinner, Ikaw, Ginoo, kaya mo ako luwason paagi kay Kristo Jesus. So believe, confess your sins, admit that you are a sinner, and then believe on the Lord Jesus Christ to open it. Nga wala na sa makaluwas pa sa imo pag sa akon, kundi si Jesus Christ ang gin. Kitungod siya lang ang gin. Nagkari sa kalibutan nga wala sala. Napatay, ginubong, kang nabanhaw sa katlong adlaw para hatagan kita sa kabuhin nga wala sing katapusan. Tuuhin na, tuuhin. Ito pa nga ipatawad mo siya. Repent of your sins. Kung ikaw Kristuhano na, I hope and I pray that you clearly realize this one. Kung ikaw pa lang sa Ginoo, thinking that you truly deserve what you're enjoying right now. You're enjoying the privilege of being called God's son, God's children, the privilege of the promises of God. I hope and I pray that you will clearly realize that we have our life, the rest of our life will never be enough. Will never be enough to completely suffice the greatness of what God has given us. So I hope and I pray that you'll continue worshiping our God. And most importantly, kung ikaw Kristuhano na, kabayan niya, hindi ikaw mahuya, hindi ikaw mahadyo sa pag-proclaim sa gospel. Kung may ara pa, kabutang kinahanglanan ng kalibutan, subong hindi na kwarta. It is the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let's pray. Lord, we thank you for thank you, Lord, for reminding us again. This is heavy. And I don't know, dear Father, if maybe some of those people who are listening may be offended to what I shared. But I pray, Lord, that the truth from your words, as plainly as it is, it will pierce our hearts and will bring us to our knees, and that we will humble our hearts, O Lord. No one is righteous, no, not one. That's sad, but a reality, truth from your word, O Lord, we have to remind ourselves again na kung wala Ginoo, ikaw nag-extend sa iyong pagpalangga, sa iyong bugay sa kabuhin namin, we are still condemned. We are still guilty of our sins. But thank you, Ginoo, tungod kinpadala niyo mo si Kristo Jesus para sa amon sa lahat. And may kami ng mga Kristohanon, we will appreciate that. That we will continually give our lives, that we will be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. Because our labor will never be in vain. But for those people that will Ginoo, wala pa nakatuo, wala pa nakabato ni Kristo Jesus, kabayan ikaw magpadayong tandong sa iyong tagipusuman, that they may surrender their lives, that they may believe as well on the Lord Jesus Christ. It is our prayer in Christ's name.